Norman and I have been knowing each other for years, and you know, we would cross paths, you know, every now and then on a jazz festival or a club gig or something, and we would always say that, man, you know, we got to do something together, and we did tidbits of stuff, you know, along the 30 years we've known each other. Mark Wexler came to us late last year and said, you know, it would be a good collaboration for you and Norman to get together and put a record together, and we said, yeah. We said, yeah, that would work.
Well, the plan was we would split the duties. We each did half the record. I did five cuts. Gerald did five cuts. We decided on a couple of cool remakes that we did. Gerald picked Champagne Light, yeah, which is a beautiful thing. I came up with Tomorrow. And we had a ball doing that. And, you know, shared in the responsibilities of the writing and the production and the overall concept of the record. So I'm very proud of what we came up with. A lot of that had to do with us inspiring each other. Yeah, Tomorrow is a tune. Always loved that tune and went back into the archives. I'm doing an interview in Milwaukee. I'm on the radio. I'm talking to a guy, Terry Hollywood Love. He played the tune for me, and the duet thing on there was really a nice blueprint for what Gerald and I were doing. I knew Gerald would just step in there with his horn and make that baby sing. Beautiful tune, everybody knows it. Again, a common chord, sing-along kind of thing. It's nice to hear you stretch out on that particular tune and take the front on it. So it was perfect for us, absolutely.
I love the arrangement that you did on it too, man.
Thanks, man. Thanks, man.
I had the distinct pleasure of playing both bass guitar and saxophone with Willie for many years. And Willie schooled me on the Latin approach, the Brazilian approach to music. And it's so festive, and it's something that's kind of in my blood now, because he really took me under his reign and said, okay, you know, this is what we're going to do. And so periodically that Latin flavor comes out, and we wanted to make this a multifaceted project. So we decided to touch on different genres, from funk to love songs to Brazilian, whatever. And that's how Buenos Amigos came.
Excited to finally get a chance to work with what I consider is one of the baddest saxophone players that we've seen in our lifetime, in my lifetime anyway. And I'm extremely honored, man, to be working with this cat under these terms. Something that's going to live on forever, and this record is going to be there when we're not, you know? And it's a real honor and a pleasure. And then to stand up live next to him and play is so inspiring, and it keeps me inspired.
Well, obviously, thank you for that. It's a mutual admiration thing, man. One of my favorite guitarists on the planet, always has been, dear friend. You know, our relationship goes beyond the instrument. You know, we have a lot in common, and it's nice to have that comfort zone both on and off the road. And I'm just, like you say, I'm very honored to be sharing the stage with you and sharing the studio with you, brother, and let's do it perpetually, man.
Absolutely.
Let's keep it going.
So we wanted to send some love out there to you guys 24/7, okay? Please receive it under those terms, and come see us live. We want to see you at the shows.
Absolutely. Yeah.